Hey everybody, welcome back to VGC Series 10, where today we're going to play this Hail team with Ho-Oh on it. I actually tried making a team like this a little while ago. It was one of the first things I tested. I was like, oh, well, if I'm going to play Hail, let me just play Hail with Ho-Oh, because I want to play them together and it sounds like it goes together. I just couldn't quite make it mesh myself. This team comes to us by the way of Dragonair Jordan. I'm pretty sure that's their name on YouTube and Twitch. So if you just want to search for them, you can do that. I think it's all one word. But I will link their YouTube and their Twitch in the description. Go check them out. They made this team. It's a pretty good team. This is actually the team that got me to Master Ball. I went ahead and grinded up to it. Mostly because it really made me stop and think and play a little bit slower. And, you know, I think I was not being as cautious before, if that makes sense. Anyway, it's a really neat team. So running Ninetales, Gastrodon, Drapion, Ho-Oh, Rillaboom, Stagateca. You have Ninetales here for the Aurora Veil. Getting Aurora Veil up with something as bulky as Ho-Oh, something as bulky as Stagateca is really, really nice because it just makes it even bulkier. I have the EV spreads, at least I had them, so I can talk about them a little bit. I have used the team a couple of times, so I can say the Ho is very specially defensive. It's not running a lot of physical bulk, so stay away from Rock Slide, because Rock Slide from Garchomp will just one-hit KO you. Stay away from it. Don't expect to live with a little bit of health. It's not EV'd for that. The Gastrodon is modest, but it's not running a whole lot of special attack investment, so you're not going to hit things very hard unless you get your Storm Drain boost, but it lives things. I don't think it'll live a Grass-type attack, so keep it away from those, but you'll live just about anything else. It's really nice. Rillaboom's not max attack. It's running a little bit of special defense, a little bit of defense. So that's really nice. You have a little bit of more longevity. That being said, if somebody happens to be running max attack Incineroar, you will not take that hit. Not that you won't know until it attacks you, but, you know. This Drapion's running quite a bit of special defense. I want to say that it's EV to take, a Water Spout, but don't quote me on that because I don't actually know. It might be EV to take the Water Spout after you already get a Aurora Veil up or something like that. And then, Stagateca here. Its defense stat's higher than its attack stat, so it's defense boosting its Stagateca, of course. It hits pretty hard. It's just offensive stack attack. I'm pretty sure it's mostly just attack investment and HP investment. With that, let's jump in. Let's see if we can get a couple of battles. I only have a little bit of time, but I didn't post a video yesterday, so I figured y'all deserve a video today, right? I just woke up and I gotta go to work after this, but that's nothing new. That's every video, right? I'm talking quietly. We're trying not to wake my wife up today. I feel like every time I say that, I wake her up. Alright, let's get it. You see, I made it to Master Ball with a negative ranking. I didn't record that climb, but man, I should have. Some of those teams were so ridiculous. No matter how much they frustrated me, they probably would have been entertaining. As always, if you like this video, leave me a like. Every like pushes the video just a little bit further and, you know, gets the video in front of more people. And that's always the goal, right? Leave me a comment. Tell me what Pokemon you want to see in VGC Series 10. I got a couple that I'm working on in the background that I'll get to. So don't yell at me, but I'm trying my best. I've been kind of busy lately. Okay, this team is kind of very similar to ours.
It's always so cold in my living room in the morning.
The AC, goes off in the middle of the night or something. So I think we can bring Ninetales pretty safely against this team. This team's so similar to ours. That's crazy. I think I'm going to bring Ninetales and Ho-Oh. And in the back, I think we have to bring Rillaboom. Do I bring the Gastrodon? I think I do. I think that's my four. Stack Attack probably would have been nice, but it doesn't like facing off against their Gastrodon. But Stack Attack does do a couple of things that are kind of important. Alright, what do you got? Aleki Entei. You know, it's kind of the lead I was afraid of, to be honest.
But you know, it's like their best lead. Why would they lead it?
Okay. Let me think about this here. I think I'm gonna protect my Ninetales. I feel like I should take one attack from this Aleki, but I'm not 100% sure about that. I'm gonna go for Sacred Fire into the Aleki. And then next turn we can switch. I feel like they're likely to just like Electro Whip Sacred Fire. Oh no, they just go for the T-Bolt. Oh, into... That's great. Oh no. I always forget about Stone Edge. Every time I see an Entei, I just forget every move that Entei learns. It's crazy. Yeah. Like I said, you're not meant to take Rock type attacks. Just don't even bother. Okay, let's get Gastrodon in, because it's pretty good against both of these mons. Maybe we can force something to switch out. I'm going to go ahead and try to get my Roar Veil up. And... see, what do they have in the back? What's likely to come in? I feel like the most obvious switch would be switching Aleki in for Yveltal, so I'm going to go ahead and Scald Entei. Did they bring Gastrodon? This person is reading me like a book. Which happens every once in a while, like... what are you gonna do? That's a big... oof, I should've Earth Powered. Gastrodon has not leftovers. I wonder if it's like Rindoberry. Alright, well let's try to Earth Power into their Aleki, but I think they're probably gonna switch. It didn't switch last turn, so actually it didn't switch this turn. They could Volt Switch though, so. No. Ooh. Okay. T-Bolt again. I really like that move. This might KO, to be honest. Whoosh, goodbye. I'm okay with that. The real question is how we're going to deal with Yveltal when it comes out. Because I don't know. I guess we can, like, Blizzard into it, but Blizzard, there's no way Blizzard's gonna one-hit KO Yveltal. I've seen that thing take... I was playing Groudon, and I got all the way up to plus four, and then Yveltal took plus four Heat Crash. Craziness. I don't have a good switch in here, so we just kinda have to hope and pray that we take whatever. Gastrodon has to switch out, right? I can't fake out Entei either. I'm gonna U-turn into that slot and go for an Earth Power onto Entei. which I probably should have just earth powered it the first time. The Hoenn champion. You've also the Hoenn champion. Ooh, they just protect, okay. Maybe they're not in their focus. That's a good move. Maybe I should start running U-turn. Ah, oh, man, losing hold of that attack hurts so much. This is gonna be our last turn of hail, right? Yeah, our only win condition against this Yveltal really is... Why, it took so much damage from the U-turn, actually. More than I would expect. I'm gonna try to get rid of this Entei, and the Ninetales will be kinda safe. Alright, no switches on their end. Extreme speed is a move. Snarl's so annoying. It can miss. No? Okay. We're gonna do, like, negative damage to this Entei. Hey, you know what? That's a two-hit KO. I think they're probably gonna extreme speed again, so it's probably in our best interest to switch into Rillaboom. They also gave up their special attack boost on Gastrodon, which is nice for us. Alright, I'm just gonna go for it again. There's not really much else I can do. They went for it. Ooh, we lived. No burn? Some people just have all the luck. Alright, we don't have a way to beat their Gastrodon, really, but they're not leftovers and we are, so maybe that helps. Can we at least KO this Entei? Alright, that's something. Oof, losing Rillaboom hurt. I thought maybe they would extreme speed again. You think this Yveltal is assault vest? Or what? This would be a nice time to be running freeze dry, wouldn't it? Okay, I think I'm gonna protect this first turn. I think I'm going to double protect just to kind of feel out what's going on here. Because if their Yveltal has protect, it's going for it this turn. Right. No protect on their side. I'm gonna say it doesn't have it. Oblivion Wing makes sense. Oblivion Wing Earth Power makes a lot of sense. If I had Freeze Dry right now, what I wouldn't give for a Freeze Dry. Earth Power here because I literally can't touch Yveltal while this Gastrodon's on the field. Which kind of sucks, actually. Ooh, okay. Maybe we can get a freeze. Maybe it's not Assault Vest. It's Assault Vest. There's no way. Please tell me we take one Oblivion Wing. Probably not. Please? Oh, that sucks so much. We're gonna lose, guys. Yeah, I think we lose. They had some real good reads on the first couple of turns of this game. Props to them. And obviously, you know, negative props to me for forgetting about Stone Edge. I don't know, this is maybe doable, but I don't have a lot of faith. They're just gonna snarl us into Oblivion. And Snarl does a ton of damage. And we do no damage. Oh my goodness. Wow. Yeah, we just lose. Evolve is so bulky, man. Alright, GG's, man. You got it. You got it. That's okay. That's not on the team. That's on me. That's my fault. Yeah, straight up, every time I face an Entei, I forget its entire moveset. I don't know why. It's every time. Like, literally every time I face Entei, I forget the extreme speed is a move. You know? Alright, let's get a good game. For me. A good game for me. Yeah? Our only out to Calyrex Shadow is Drapion. Okay. Let me think about this for a second. This is a really aggressive team. I want to lead Ho-Oh still, I think. Do we bring Stack Attacker? I guess we could lead Stack Attacker. A Trick Room would be pretty nice, huh? Alright, let's go Stack Rillaboom, Drapion, Ho-Oh. And then hopefully this Urshifu Rapid Strike doesn't just come in and wreck our team. Hopefully it's Dark-type Urshifu, right? But it is probably Urshifu Rapid Strike. Is the meta's adjustment to stuff like Ho-Oh being really good. And how good Incineroar is, you know, etc., etc. Okay, I can deal with this lead. This lead's not that bad. We should take one Astral Barrage, I think. Didn't they have Taunt? I'm getting the Trick Room up. I think that's our best bet here. And then I'm just gonna fake out the Whimsicott in case it has Taunt. We should take an Astral Barrage with both of these mons. I mean, I don't necessarily know how well we take it. We should at least take it, and then once we Trick Room up, Stack Attack it could just do whatever. Ooh, we don't have to take the Astral Barrage. Urshifu comes in. I'm okay with that. It is Dark type Urshifu. Even better. That was a priority move. I'm thinking they went for taunt. And now I'm really not too scared of these Pokemon. I think I'm just going to double up into Urshifu here to make sure we get rid of it. Of course, saying that, they're probably just going to detect, right? I guess we'll see. Switch into who? Into Lele. To take away my priority. Well, that doesn't matter because Rillaboom's slower than Urshifu anyway. And Tepu Lele does not want to take a Gyro Ball. If they're not Sash, this might just KO. No? Okay, well, it's fine. This will definitely KO. Yeah. Go Stack Attacka. What's your birthday? Mim comes back in. Alright. I'm okay with that. I think the Tepu Lele is scarier, so I'm just gonna Gyro Ball there. And I'll U-turn on the Whimsicott. Oof. Goodbye. Plus defense. What does the Whimsicott do here? I think I bring in Drapion just to get a KO on the Calyrex at my leisure. And they made a big mistake letting me get the... Ooh, they have Trick Room. Okay. Alright. That's a good call. Alright, I think I'm just gonna straight up Gyro Ball into this and knock off into this. We should take whatever from the Calyrex. At least Drapion should. I wonder if it's Sash. I guess we're gonna find out. Grass Knot. How much does that do? I wonder if that's more than Astral Barrage. It's Life Orb. Alright, well then we just win, I think. Goodbye, Calyrex. Peace, homie. And then Gyro Ball. Nice. Stack Attacka is the MVP of that game. Ho-Oh didn't even touch the field. Sometimes it'd be like that. Ho-Oh is not the kind of mon that you can bring to every game. And sometimes that's hard to accept with your restricted Pokemon, you know? I think we got time for one more. Which, we should play one more because I don't want a video with just two battles in. That'd be dumb, right? Okay, Jilba. Another Yveltal team. The Aerodactyl looks kind of scary, doesn't it? I think I want to lead Ninetales with Rillaboom, maybe? Let's bring Ho-Oh. And then the back, let's bring Stack Attacker, I think. And let's bring Rillaboom. Bringing Rillaboom might be a mistake, but we might need the Fake Out Pressure. And I kind of don't want to bring Gastrodon, I think. I guess it could be Rapid Strike Urshifu.
And it's pretty good to a Lackey.
It's at least okay in the Volcarona. Maybe we should have brought Gastrodon. It just doesn't do very well in the Yveltal. Which I guess Rillaboom doesn't either. But at least Rillaboom has Fake Out Pressure. Stadium, huh? It is Rapid Strike Urgency. Okay. Wow. I might be in trouble then, actually. Yeah, I'm feeling we should have brought Gastrodon. Oh, I have Moonblast. I didn't notice that before. Alright, I'm gonna Blizzard and switch into Rillaboom. Because they're likely to just kind of like wrap Surging Strikes into Ho-Oh, and I'm not confident that we take that. They're also kind of likely to just, you know, like Rock Slide with their Aerodactyl. I wonder if it's carrying Bulldoze. The sooner we get rid of this Aerodactyl, the better. And if anything... we should be able to get rid of Urshifu next turn, as long as we don't lose anything here. Tailwind is a move. U-turn. Okay. Into who? Show me the Yveltal. Let me Blizzard into it. Tailwind is not what I was expecting. But I probably should have, to be honest. Oh, not Volcarona. We don't even KO the Aerodactyl. That's not good. Okay, I think I'm gonna protect my Ninetales. And... I think my play is Grassy Glide into Aerodactyl, but we'll see what Volcarona does, I guess. No Protect. Alright, goodbye Aerodactyl. Struggle Bug. Okay, well, we didn't need to protect Ninetales, I guess, but... we are going to take some damage on our Rillaboom. That's a decent chunk for Struggle Bug. We could have gotten our Wurlvet off, probably. We don't have any Rock type coverage, I don't think. But we do have Ho-Oh. Ho-Oh at least has flying coverage. Why could I stall out this Tailwind? Like, two more turns of it, I think? Sometimes I forget how to count Tailwind. That's a play. Alright, I'm gonna switch Ho-Oh in on this slot, because it's more likely to take a Fire-type attack, I think. I'm gonna switch Stack Attack in here, because it's more likely to take a Flying-type attack. And I feel like that's pretty safe. Oh, we do have rock coverage, obviously. We have Stack Attack. What was I saying? It might even be safe just to straight up, like, Trick Room next turn, depending on how much damage we take here. Fiery Dance. Perfect. Perfect, perfect. Don't get the special attack raise. Great. Alright, looks like we called their moves correctly. I think I'm just gonna Brave Bird into Volcarona and Trick Room. Because if Urshifu switches in here, I would like to catch it on the switch in. I don't know how much damage we take from a Dark type attack, but I think I have to get Trick Room up here. Because Stack Attack, it can really just go off and start sweeping from there. Fiery Dance and Stack Attack, I probably. Ooh, this double up my KO, I'll have to go for it. Oh yeah, they went for it. Oh! Stack Attack, you're beautiful. Okay. Alright, this might be doable. That's a lot of recoil. Oh no. Oh no! Stack Attack! I said you were beautiful and everything. Why did you flinch? Okay, let's get Ninetales in. Because we can just Moonblast on the Urshifu at least to KO it. If they're running U-turn, there's a good chance they're not running Protect, right? I wonder if it's Scarf. I'm gonna switch into Rillaboom on this slot. I'm gonna go for the Moonblast, and we're gonna hope we get it off. We have had an opportunity to see what the item is on the Urshifu. I'm hoping it's not. If it's not Scarf, I think we'll be okay. Like, literally anything but Scarf. If it's Choice Band, we'll be fine. Because Moonblast should KO. I guess if it's Sash, we might be in trouble, but we do have Hail. Aqua Jet. Alright, well, that's fine. It's not Sash. I think it's Banned. They did a lot of damage with Aqua Jet. It's probably Banned. Oblivion Wing. Into Ninetales, probably, right? Oh no! They called our switch correctly. I don't think they took too much damage though, so all the chip matters. All the chip does matter. Okay, I think our players definitely fake out and switch into Ho-Oh. They only got one mon left, but it's a mon that could very potentially 3v1 us if we're not careful. Okay, that's nice. I might have to let them take Rillaboom. I'm gonna try to U-turn. And I think I want a Sacred Fire, because I like the idea of getting a burn off. Especially since we're going to get Hail and we can get Chip with Hail and Burn, it's just a lot of damage. We're faster, okay. Get the burn, please? Thank you. Dark Pulse? Alright, that's fine. We get to U-turn, or two. That's nice. I think we just KO this Evolve next turn. I don't think there's any way they take a Blizzard. I'll have after Hail and Burn, they have like no HP. I don't even think they live Hail and Burn next turn. Blizzard. I'm gonna go ahead and switch into Rillaboom just in case. Ninetales can use healing. Oh, okay. All right, well, that's the team. That's the game. GG's. How much you thought of it? I think it's a pretty good team. I've enjoyed using it, what I have. You know. Once again, if you like this video, leave me a like. If you have ideas for Pokemon that you haven't been able to make work yourself, leave me a comment. I'll try my best to make them work, and if I can, I'll make a video about it. Join the AndyLa Discord server. You can challenge me to battles. Just get advice from me, anything you want there. Check out Dragonair Jordan. They made this team, obviously. They make VGC content. They got a Twitch and a YouTube. I'll try to link both in the description. check out Pokemon VGC Talk. That's T-A-L-K. Don't think about it like TikTok, because it's not a TikTok. I have a TikTok, but it's not that. It's linked in the description. We just had a video come out yesterday, and I would really appreciate if y'all could just go sub to that channel, help it grow. We're all trying really hard to, you know, collaborate with each other, and it's really nice. And if you're not subscribed, and you're here all the way at the end of the video, what are you doing, man? Just subscribe. There's going to be, like, a little link on the screen to subscribe in, like, 2 seconds. Just do it. With that, my name's Andrew. I'll catch you guys next time.